Well, they've had four tackles and he's made three of them. He's pretty effective.
Isn't Takahashi's a big boy. He's big and strong. Wraps up well. Once again, the showing blitz from the outside. Blitz is coming. Hand off to number two. Another Lopez. This time it was handed off to Juan Antonio Lopez Santana.
Outside zone play. Saw a crease. Turned up. Excellent gain.
There is a little bit of yellow laundry on the field. See what the flag is for. Be a holding call. Holding call against number 59.
Yesterday's game,
Marco
had
Martin.
Quite a few penalties called throughout the game, and it's really been something been pretty much absent of throughout the tournament. But yesterday, the few more of them, and we start off today with one.
Brings up second down and 20 for Mexico.
Down and 19 yards to go for Mexico.
Have an empty set in the backfield.
Garcia looking to throw his left side deep down to number four. Off his back shoulder. Well thrown ball by the quarterback. Ignacio Guerrero, the intended receiver.
I guess if you hit your receiver to back the head, you've pretty well done your job as a quarterback, right? In the receiver's defense, ball may have been tipped.
Once again, empty backfield. Fernandez, the quarterback this time. Tries to run himself, hit at the line of scrimmage.
Ball stripped out. Team Japan has it.
They're going to
call it. I don't think he was down.
They're going to call a forward motion.
I don't think he was
stopped.
Down. I know he wasn't on the floor. I don't think his momentum or his, they had ruled his motion stopped. First down, Japan. First turnover of the game. Put the ball on 31-yard line. This is a little closer to the 32, probably.
First and 10, Japan at the 32-yard line.
First time Team Japan's had the ball on offense.
They get it with great field position. Japan looking quick pass out to the right side.
Got the big
number 11
big,
still
big
on
big
his feet.
Center.
Hurdling over, fumbles the football.
The
picked up
out.
By Mexico, being returned. Out of bounds at the 15. A few words been exchanged between the players on the sideline there. Completion to Tonka from Ishiuchi.
It was a great offensive
tried to
play.
Tried to hurdle over the defense, but the ball popped out, picked up by Mexico, returned to the 15-yard line.
They may call him down by contact. They may say the ground. No, that ball was out well before he hit the ground.
That ball was popped out while he was still
there. They don't have the luxury of replay like we do.
No, they don't.
But in a way, it's too bad they don't.
Team Mexico indicating
what that call would be.
During the play, in a word, the whistle. The player lost the ball. The loose ball is immediately taken by the defensive team. The ball belongs to Mexico.
A little bit quick on the whistle were the referees. To understand the confusion by the players on the field.
They may be less confused than I am.
The ball to Tatsuya Tonka, number 11.
So Mexico will take over at the 10-yard line.
Leading to a first and 10.
They'll mark it where the ball was acquired by Mexico, not to where they returned it. Garcia back in the game. Hand off to Lopez. Gets a couple of yards. Running
very
back.
Very good at finding that first seam.
Juan Antonio Lopez.
Juan Lopez, number two. Tackled by Itsuki Kato.
Nice gain on first down.
A 4-yard gain. It brings up second and six for Mexico from the 14-yard line.
Single back in the backfield. You're going to see that pretty much all day from Team Mexico.
Garcia looking to throw once again. Quick throw out of bounds. He was under pressure there. They're off, not on the same page as his receiver. Offensive coordinator pointing other side of the field. As Alberto Lopez comes into the game again. Quarterback calling a timeout.
Some confusion on Mexico. Don't know whether.
Good, exciting first quarter of play here, Coach. 7:58 remaining in the first quarter. Japan and Mexico, no score yet.
Seen two turnovers. I'm sure both coaching staffs don't want that trend to continue, particularly on for their team at least. We'll see how that plays out as well. Team Mexico was able to establish a first down on a quick exchange by their punt team. So that worked out good for them. They also had a nice return on their kickoff. So far special teams has been an advantage for Team Mexico. But we're only into the game 4 minutes.
Third down and six for the Mexican offense. 14-yard line. Garcia, quarterback, and Lopez in the backfield. Double slot. The Japan showing blitz off the edge once again. Lopez goes in motion. Looking to throw. Garcia, lots of time. Finally, whales one out to Lopez. Caught at the 45-yard line. Brought down at the 48.
That's a running back that swung out and run a wheel route to his right.
I was keeping my eye on that offensive line. There's beautiful blocking being handled down there.
I actually thought he was going to a corner post route by his wide receiver.
Hurry up offense by the Mexicans. Handoff to Lopez up the middle. Gain of about 4.5. They'll mark it at a 4-yard gain. Bring up second and six.
Tackled by number 55, Gendai Takechi.
The Mexican team showing speed, getting the ball going real quick. Now they slow it down a little bit on second down. Garcia looking to throw again, gets the ball out of the pocket. Intercepted at the 35-yard line.
I think calling him out of bounds.
Pass is ruled incomplete. Player caught the ball out of bounds.
He broke hard on that ball, Coach.
Safety did a nice job of reading it.
Mexico.
Looked like his foot came right down on the line.
Second step was definitely out. I think his first step probably hit the line, as you said. I know the official was right on top of it, so I'm sure he made the right call.
Brings up third and six for Mexico. Double slot formation, single back. Garcia at quarterback. Garcia looking to throw once again. Pressure coming. Finally gets the ball loose through the hands of the running back, Salvador Sierra Lopez.
The quarterback, Alejandro Garcia, gets pressure from number 40, Shogo Nakatani.
Watch the outside linebacker off the right side.
Brings a Mexican punter back on the field once again.
Fourth down
Armando Chivion.
Good punt, nice booming punt. Be bouncing towards the end zone. It'll go to touchback. He punted from where they usually kick off, Coach.
There wasn't much pressure on that punt. Mexico's coaches may notice that.
Brings the Japanese offense on the field. Ichiuchi at the quarterback. Sakaguchi at tailback. Ichiuchi looking to throw, nowhere to go. Gets hit hard in the middle. Lots of pressure. They'll be marked down as a 1 yard loss.
Good pressure by the Mexican defensive line there.
Lost for a couple yards.
Bring up second and 11 for Japan.
They're almost halfway through the quarter, and that's the second play Japan's offense has been on the field. So I'm sure they're looking to get something started here.
Ichiuchi throwing down the center of the field through the arms of his intended receiver, number 7, Shin Takasaki. Brings up third and 11 for the Japanese. Pro formation. Little play action. Ball thrown out over the head of intended receiver Takasaki. Ichiuchi and Takasaki aren't on the same page today, Coach.
Wasn't too much pressure on the quarterback. They were hooked up on that play before. It just went through the hands. And one of the first times in 9 days that Japanese punt team has been on the field. Got one player getting out late. Looks like they're lining up in a shield punt formation. Some
Shintaro's Saeki, the
about
punter.
Where they're lining up. Five men to their right.
Gets the ball off just in time.
Nice
big
punt.
High
Very
hang
nice
time.
Punt. Very Take, nice punt.
Taken at the 36-yard line. They'll mark him at the 37.
Forty-six-yard punt in the air.
That punt has some hang time on it there, Coach.
That was an excellent punt. He had a lot of pressure. He certainly answered an early question anyway about their punting.
Garcia and company once again on the field. Three receivers to the right side. Hand off to Lopez up the left side. Breaks free for about a 12-yard gain. Ball will be marked down at the... Ball is marked at the 38-yard line.
Or
excuse me, 48-yard line.
In that, all, or in that defense.
Bring it first and 10.
Before.
Once again, three.
Sort of asking them to run the football.
Three receivers to the right side. This time, Garcia keeps the ball, gets another 10 yards.
Team Mexico is obliging them, too.
Marked at the 41-yard line, and that's first and 10 once again for the Mexican offense.
Ha ha ha!
Garcia looking to throw. Quick screen out to the right side to number 44.
Nice open field tackle there.
Nicholas Cedric Contla Para.
Gets a gain of about 2 yards. Bring up second down and 8 for the team from Mexico. Garcia once again keeps the ball, still on his feet, inside the 25-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 24. Good reads by the quarterback here. As you're saying, Coach, they're just wanting them to run.
They're
25-yard line, first and 10, Mexico.
Those particular defensive sets, all they brought a couple more linemen on. I think they're going to come out of that 3-3 look.
So you got Garcia and Lopez in the backfield. Three receivers to the left side. Garcia keeps the ball. Stiff arms and gets tackled for a loss. Bit of acrobatics on the field there.
Sack of the game by Kevin Cotlin, number 5 of Waseda University. For a loss of 5 yards, second and long, Mexico.
Brings up second and 15 for Mexico. After the loss, after the quarterback's bootleg there. Spread formation for Mexico, single back. Tailback in motion. Garcia looking to throw, going down the middle. A little bit short on the pass, intended for number 6.
Ricardo Cervantes, the intended receiver.
I believe if the ball would have been up high enough for the receiver to catch it, it might have got intercepted.
Brings up 3rd and 15 for Mexico.
About a 46-yard field goal if they did fail to pick up any yards. That would be, I would say, just about the kicker's extreme length.
Delay a game will be called against the
flag on the play.
Mexican offense.
There's no flag, there's no penalty. Team Mexico took a timeout before the flag. Mexico timeout.
Team Mexico, no flag on play. Team Mexico calls timeout with the final second of the game clock. 2:43 remaining in the first quarter of play. The score is 0-0, Japan and Mexico. We'd like to thank our sponsors and volunteers for this last week and helping us out with this first ever World University of America Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden.
I sat down in a chair, Will, and it's windier down here when I'm sitting down. I think I'm going to have to stand back up.
Bit of a breeze coming in from the east here.
It'll be interesting to see what team Mexico comes up here with. Challenged the middle of the field much yet.
3rd and 15 for Mexico from the 28-yard line. Garcia and Lopez in the backfield. Alberto Lopez. Garcia looking to throw. Middle screen out to Lopez near the original down marker. That'll bring up fourth and 10.
Number three, Alberto Lopez, tackled by number five, Kevin
Crosswood. Field
goal unit. Get to see the leg strength of the kicker.
Looks like the ball's on about the 24.
Fernando Rubalcaba Torres is the kicker of the day.
41-yard field goal attempt. Basically from the right hash.
Rubalcaba's kick is up. And no good. That leaves us at 0-0. Japan and Mexico with 1:47 remaining in the first quarter.
Pulled the kick a little.
Makes the game kind of exciting, doesn't it, Coach?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Leading to a turnover on downs. And Japan will start their offense at the 23-yard line, first and 10.
Kicker also starts at linebacker for Mexico.
And once again, Ishiuchi looking to throw, going to his right side. Receiver's out of bounds, makes the catch, but he was well out of bounds. Shin Takasaki, the receiver.
Shin Takasaki from Takuya Ishiuchi, number 18. Is ruled incomplete. The player caught the ball out of bounds. Second and 10.
Chinese contingent rooting for the Mexican defense here. Ishiuchi hands off, keeps the ball himself. Gets a gain of about a yard. It'll bring up third down and long. For the Japanese offense. Well disciplined defensive line there. Ishiuchi looking to throw, going down the middle of the field, wide open, number 89. Yuji Mizuno, kid that you and I like quite a lot.
He's been one of my favorites throughout the tournament. Not only what he can do, but his versatility.
Number 89, Yuji Mizuno.
Ball will be marked down at the 49-yard line of Japan. First and 10.
First and 10, Japan.
Tight end down the middle sometimes. Very effective against cover two.
Ishiuchi looking to throw once again. The shovel pass up the middle of number 28. Haven't seen that play yet. Shu in a way.
Number 28. The running back out of Ritsumeikan University.
Gets a gain of about 4 yards. Brings up second and six from the Mexico 47-yard line. Hand off to in a way once again. Gets a couple more yards. Bring up third and four. Excuse me, that brings up third and three. And that brings us to the end of the first quarter of play here in Uppsala, Sweden. Score is 0-0. Japan versus Mexico in the final game, game number 10 of the 2014 World University American Football Championship.
Resulting in 0-0, no score in an evenly played game so far. Both teams looking for the first points of the game.
change that, right?
Mexico is 89, 48 rushing yards and 41 passing yards. For Japan, it's a total offense of 56 yards, 51 of them from passes.
Third and three from the 44-yard line. Swing pass out the running back number 34. Hit short of the first goal marker.
Ball goes to number 34.
Number 18 did a fine job of playing off the block.
No gain.
Umehara on the reception and run.
And Japan brings in the punting team.
Punt team in Japan comes onto the field. Saeki will probably put this one into the end zone. Or close to it. Very close to it, I suspect. Watch this kid warming up on Friday, and he was booming them. Placed kick to the right side. It bounces and will be downed in the. Nope, I thought they got it out. But it will go in as touchback.
Punt goes to the end zone.
Got the angle on it, but he didn't get much air in it.
And we have a first and 10 at the 20 yard line.
Any which way, it's a good punt.
Adjust the clock to 11 minutes.
Slight clock adjustment here. It doesn't look like the clock's been running at all in this final quarter, or second quarter. One minute played in the second quarter of the game. Garcia hands off to Lopez, bounces his way up, gets a couple of yards, flag comes flying in from the umpire. Gets a gain of about 5 yards.
Run up the middle by Juan Lopez, number two. Stopped by number 35, Yuki Ishii, and a flag on the plate.
Holding, Mexico, number 69.
Number 69 of Mexico. Called for holding. Emmanuel Alonso Padilla.
And the holding results in a 10-yard penalty. So we have first down and 20 for Mexico.
Garcia, Lopez in the backfield. Hand off to Lopez. Excuse me, Sierra Lopez.
Run by number one, Salvador Sierra. For a gain of about 1 yard. Second down and 19.
Gets a 1 yard gain, and after the penalty, they'll make it second then. Okay. 17. Garcia looking to throw, going deep down his left side, through the hands of his receiver, inches, coach, inches, half a step, he would have had that one.
Right over the fingertips, you hung it up there about as good as you can.
Double coverage.
And good defensive work by number 17 in Japan, Yu Kitamura.
Show that play once again. That was a beauty. We've got a good angle on it here. Half a step more and he would have had that ball.
Offensive line giving him a good time to throw.
Like you and I were talking about before the game there, Coach, that I thought that the Japanese defensive backs haven't been challenged yet this game or this tournament. And Mexicans are coming out and challenging off the bat. Yes,
flag on the
flag. On the flag. Do you believe the play clock ran down? Unfortunate mistake for the team of Mexico. Already at third and 16 and move it back to third and 21.
Leading to a third down and 24 situation for Mexico.
Drop eight into coverage.
Hand off up the middle of Lopez. Still on his feet. Close to the first down and more. Still going to midfield. Inside the 40-yard line, brought down at the 37. They'll mark him down at the 35-yard line. One heck of a run by number two, Juan Antonio Lopez Santana.
Nice call. The Mexican contingent still even got a couple of masked wrestlers in the stands.
Grips to the left.
Garcia and Lopez in the backfield. Lopez Sierra, excuse me. Garcia being flushed out of the pocket. Pressure coming from the outside. Keeps the ball, throws it out complete to number seven, Jose Mario Sanchez Padilla.
The quarterback, Alejandro Garcia, scrambles around in the backfield for a while before he finds the receiver, Jose Sanchez.
See how they flag on the sideline.
I think he might have crossed the line of scrimmage before he threw that ball. That's in the area where the flag is thrown.
Might have been a late hit out of bounds as well. Sure, Team Mexico thinks it's on Japan anyway.
Personal foul, number 44, Team Japan. First down, Mexico.
You're right, Coach. A personal foul against number 44 of Japan. Keisuke Ota. Charge of penalty, linebacker. Half the distance, first and goal from the 10.
Goal at the 10-yard line for Mexico.
.855 remaining in the first half of the game. Score is 0-0, Japan and Mexico. Clock is rolling. Play clock down to 9. Garcia hands it. Quick option out to number 3, Lopez. Touchdown, Mexico. He just rolled right over the top of that tackler and into the end zone.
And Mexico is up.
Got a good angle on the camera here.
Faked the veer dive to the fullback. Haven't run him all day, but they still faked it. And an effective deception on the part of Mexican offense.
Rivacapa to do the extra kick. It is good. Brings us to 7. Mexico draws first blood in this final game of the championship here in UPPSALA this week. Score is 7-0, Mexico over Japan. 8 minutes, 27 seconds remaining.
The
in the half.
Effective throughout this game. A little bigger.
Rybakova with a little kick from the 35. Back return for Japan is number 88. Kinoshita. Boom and kick high in the air, taken at the goal line by Kinoshita. Up the right side, still on his feet. Taken out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Stopped at the
22-yard
line, first and 10 for Japan.
Takuya Ishiuchi, the quarterback for Japan. Flags flying everywhere.
On the play. That drive to Mexico leading to the touchdown consisted of five plays
looks
for
to be
total of 80 yards.
They'll call a false start in the offense here. Unless I saw something different.
Illegal procedure. Illegal snap. Team Japan. 5 yards penalty. In first down.
Center double snap the ball, which is a no-no. Get you a false start every time. Moves the ball back 5 yards to the 17-yard line. First and 15 for Japan. Ishiuchi hands off up the middle. Takaguchi, who gets back about 4 yards. Bring up second and 11 for Japan.
Kazuki Takaguchi for no gain, second down and 10. Correction, a gain of 5 yards, second down and 10.
Ishiuchi keeps the ball himself. Flag on the play. Excuse me, a quarterback change.
Run by number 10, Kyogo Kishimura.
Kishimura is in now.
Flag on the play.
Referee threw the flag.
Looks to be against Mexico. Against Japan. They're looking to decline it. Not. Holding on the offense.
Holding. Japan, number 56. 10 yards.
Attack on a 10-yard penalty. Bring up second and 21 for Japan. From the 11-yard line. Japan's offense has been going backwards of late instead of forwards. Kishimura gives the ball to Takaguchi for a hard run.
Ball goes to number 3, Kazuki Takaguchi.
Gets a gain of about 5 yards, brings up third and 16.
For a loss of 5 yards, third and long.
Swing pass out to number 7, Japan. Out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Shin
Takasaki on the reception.
Down and eight.
6:27 remaining in the half. Japanese punter Saeki.
Interesting alignment here. Got one guy over here on this side. The snapper.
Punt is out. Good high spiraling punt. Be taken great at punt. The 34-yard line. Fair catch.
Got lots of flags over. I don't know what.
And we have flag on the plate.
Wait to see what the call is here. Offsetting penalties. So it'll be a Mexican first down from the 34-yard line.
About a 42-yard punt. 42-yard net to gain. Very good. Japanese punter's been very effective so far today. Team Mexico has two backs in the backfield this time.
Throw set for the Mexicans. Hand off to Lopez. Hit quickly in the backfield. Good surge by the Japanese defense. They'll bring it down as a loss of 5 yards.
He didn't have anything to do with that fullback that time.
Run by Juan Lopez. Tackled by number 98, Takoya Seike. For a loss of 5 yards, second and long.
Second and 15 for your Mexico from the 29-yard line. Single back, trips to the right side. Garcia waiting for the snap. Looking to throw, but hands off. Another loss of 2 yards. A little draw play there.
By number one, Salvador Sierra.
Japanese defense swarming in quickly into the backfield.
The play picked up about 50 yards for him while ago.
No gain, third and long.
Spread formation, single back. Alberto Lopez in the backfield.
In the slot.
Garcia looking to throw. Tucking the ball and running with it instead. For no gain.
Quarterback Alejandro Garcia, number 12.
Bring up fourth down. The punting team will take the field.
Before he's
good defensive
Kevin
stand by the Japanese defense there, coach.
Yes, it was.
Quick snap. Punt is up. It'll be a short punt. Coming down near the sideline of Mexico. Marked out of bounds at the Japanese 45.
Yard line. And Japan will bring in their offense. Still, the score is 7-0 with 4 minutes to go of the first half.
4 minutes and 1 second remaining in the first half of play of the 2014 World American Football Championship. Mexico leading Japan by 7-0.
Number
Japanese quarterback is taken down for a sack by big pressure by number 93. Francisco Jorge Kraus Gonzalez gets credited with the sack, and that'll be a loss of about 14 yards on that sack.
Second down and 23.
Brings up second and 24 for Japan. It's huge. You're having a hard day at the office today. Ishiushi hands off to number three, Takaguchi. Gets back three of those yards I lost.
Stop by number 555,
Mexico, their last timeout.
Mexico calls their last timeout of the half with 3:14 remaining on the clock. Kishimoto runs the ball up the middle for himself, gets over the 40-yard line. Bring up fourth down and 14 for Japan.
Number 10, Kiyoko Kishimoto, the quarterback of Kansai University, runs with the ball himself. Picks up a gain of about 7 yards, and we still have fourth and long for Japan.
Saiki's punt is up and will bounce. Bounces inside the 30-yard line. It'll be down near the 21. Rolls back towards the Japanese. It'll be down to the 23.
The punter, number 16, Shintaro Saiki. Kicks the ball to the 22-yard line. And Mexico will start their offense. First and 10.
Brings up first and 10 from the 24 for the Mexican offense.
I suppose either their head coach, Mexico, or their quarterback. Or it could be number three, Lopez.
We'll try to get Alberto Lopez Silva on the camera for you at halftime.
Run by number two, Juan Lopez.
From Mexico.
Number 31, Akira Unuki. For a gain of 4 yards, second and six. Second and seven.
Garcia looking to throw once again out to his left side. Flags flying. Complete to number 19.
Pass to number 19,
Jose Manuel Barrios. Flag on the play.
To the 30-yard line. Flag on the play.
Holding, Mexico, number 56. Senior penalty, still second down.
Mexico penalizes the 5 yards.
That leads Mexico to a second and 17.
excuse me, penalized 10 yards, brings up second and 17. 1:44 remaining in the half. Quarterback Garcia calls his own number, gets about a yard of that yardage back.
Alejandro Garcia of Team Mexico.
Team Mexico says, okay, let's just settle. We're our seven,
third and 15.
7 point lead.
And we have third down and 14.
Clock ticking down to under 1 minute now. Garcia hands off the, excuse me, passes out to the right side. Complete. Gets a gain of about 4 yards. Japan takes their timeout there.
And we welcome
didn't really see who caught the ball, or if they caught the ball.
He caught it. I thought he went out of bounds, so I wasn't sure why they would call a timeout, but maybe he didn't. Nonetheless, we'll all be faced with a punting situation for team from Mexico, which they had good pressure on the last time they punted, resulted in a short punt. See what type of return team from Japan wants to execute here, or whether they want to put pressure on the kicker. It's like they got a vice situation out there on one of the slots, but the inside guy's looking a lot to the inside, so I don't know what he's gonna do. There he goes, creeping
Mondo
off the edge.
Chalon with the punting. Beautiful punt. That's going to bounce inside the 10 and roll into the end zone for a touchback.
Yeah, that's a it's a 76-yard punt. It's going to be a 56-yard net. And most of that was in the air. I'm not quite sure how much of it was rolled.
That kid's got a leg, I can tell you that much.
Everybody in the stands went, whoo!
As a special teams coach, you love seeing things like that, don't you?
Well, yes, but you don't see a punt like that very often.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line for the Japanese. Araki, the quarterback, hands off to number 34, Umehara, gets a gain of about a yard and a half. Bring up second and 8.
Number 34, Shuno Umehara, tackled by Fernando Chavaria for a gain of 2 yards, second down and 8.
And that brings the end of the first half of play in Uppsala, Sweden of the 2014 World of University of American Football Championship. We'll try to bring you an interview here with Alberto Lopez Silva.
Up with a Mexico lead, 7-0. Mexico has a total yardage of 177, 118 rushing yards and 59 passing yards. Japan has a total yardage of 67 yards.
Not much to show you from the first half except for one touchdown. And here it is. Quick pitch out to Lopez. Somersaulting over the defender into the end zone after the contact.
The last couple yards on his own. Other than that, design of the play as well as the blocking from the exterior.
Souvenirs and supporter gear in the tent next to the bleachers.
Happy kid there, scoring the first touchdown of the final game.
And the game sponsors of today are the Agricultural University of Uppsala and Uppsala University.
Today's sending is brought to you by the Uppsala University School of Agriculture and the Uppsala University itself. We thank them for their sponsorship to help bring this wonderful tournament to you. The first ever World University of American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden.
Did we miss our guy or is he coming? Okay.
They got a hold of him. I see him walking with a couple of pretty ladies over there.
We'll bring you Alberto Lopez Silva here in a couple of minutes, but my thoughts on the first half of the game, it was quite even. Saw a lot of special teams. Both punt teams are on the field.
To me, the difference
field goal unit was on the field.
To me, the difference has been the team from Mexico's offensive line. They've been more.
Alberto, very good half. I'm sure you're very excited to get in the end zone with that run. What's your feeling about the game so far?
Kind of games, we are only 7 points up, so we have to take care of the ball, don't give up big plays, and keep running the ball. They just can't stop the run, so focus on the run, keep the ball in our hands. And
I just got through making a comment up here that I think your offensive line has been very productive. What's it look like down there from your point of view?
Well, they're awesome guys, so each time we get the ball, we are able to run at least 2 or 3 yards. So if we continue to run the ball with those 2 or 3 yards, it's our game. So the focus is in running the ball.
Very good. I'll let my partner here ask you a question, but I just want to wish you good luck in the second half.
Thank you very much.
Alberto, I'm not going to ask any football questions. I'm just going to ask you, do you watch the stream sending after you've got back to the hotel? Do you watch any of the broadcasts?
Yeah, I did.
I hope you watch today's, because that's a highlight film, that little somersault into the end zone there.
Great, thank you very much.
It looked great on camera, and I hope your family watched it.
Yeah, I hope so. And
if you want to give a shout out to Mexico, go right ahead.
Yeah, given the opportunity.
Go right ahead, do it in Spanish.
Vamos Mexico, vamos por la de oro.
Thank you, Alberto.
Thank you very much.
That brings the end of the first half of play at the 2014 World University Championships. Mexico versus Sweden. Mexico on top, 7-0 over Japan. And that'll bring the end of our sending for the first half. We welcome you back to the second half, and enjoy our break. Thank you. And we are back for the second half of the 2014 World American Football Championship, University Football Championship here in Uppsala, Sweden. Final game between Japan and Mexico. Mexico is leading the game with 7-0 over Japan. Expect to see pretty much the same we saw in the first half, Coach.
Well, I think Team Japan needs to get their passing game going. I think they've feel that I'm going on what their game plan looked like it was, that they don't feel they can consistently run on the superior size of the Team Mexico's defensive line, so they want to throw the ball, and they need to get that going, and they're going to get a chance right out the gate because they're going to receive the ball, or I anticipate them receiving the ball because they deferred their choice first half and have the choice second half, so I imagine they'll receive and see what they can get going offensively.
As we're waiting for the referees to initiate the second half of the game here, watching the Mexican punter casually punt 50-yard punts into the end zone. Kickoff team for their Mexico has taken the field.
Looks like they feel they're going to be kicking from the end zone to our right.
Kicking with the wind coming from their right to their left. More or less blowing straight in our face up in the booth here. Clear signal is given to the teams on the field. Mexico breaking out of their huddle, lining up for the kick. Rivalcaba's kick is straight down the center of the field, deep, taken in the end zone for touchback by number 88 of Japan. Kinoshita showing good judgment by not trying to return that.
Took all the question about the kickoff coverage question. Kicker kicked it into the end zone, resolved the issue.
Start of the second half, Japanese have changed the quarterback number 12. Yoshiro Araki is that quarterback.
Lined up, trips formation. Number 89, our versatile tight ends, lined up as an inside slot receiver.
Single back Inoue.
In motion to an H-back
hand set. Off to Inoue. Up the left side, bit of a zone play there. Gain of about 5 yards.
Number 89. They'll
mark it down as a 6-yard gain. Brings up second and 4. Takanaki now in the backfield. Takaguchi gets his number called, gets close to the first down marker. They'll mark him across the 30-yard line at first down Japan.
Well, we hadn't seen that established all first half. Don't believe they made a first down on the ground.
Araki hands off to Inoue. Same play up the middle again. Gets a gain of about 4.5. They'll mark it as a 5-yard gain. It'll bring up 2nd and 5 for Japan.
They like running that play to their left. They have in the past 3 games. And
well, between big number right, 74 and 77 there, I'd do it myself.
Doing that start second half here.
Araki hands off once again to Inoue. No gain. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss.
Brings up a 3rd and long. Bring up receiver unit coming in.
Bring up 3rd and 7 for Japan. Rocky looking to throw the ball down the right side. Complete the number 11 at the 46-yard line. Tatsuya Tonka on the reception. Brings up 1st and 10 from the 46-yard line of Japan. Araki gives the ball to Inoue up the right side, turns the corner, still on his feet, inside the 40-yard line, brought down at the 38. Move the chains once again for the Japanese, 1st and 10 from the 38-yard line.
That's a young man we made a couple comments about right at the beginning of the broadcast. Had a great game, Japan's first game here in the tournament.
Hand off to Takaguchi off the left side once again. Still on his feet.
Flag come in late.
Flag's flying.
Run by Kazuki Takaguchi.
Move the ball about 4 yards. Face mask against the defense. That'll march the ball 15 yards closer to the end zone. Mauricio Salazar Cavazos is the man called for the face mask. That places the ball on the 20-yard line. It would be 1st and 10 for Japan.
First time they've been deep into Team Mexico's territory today.
Araki hands off the ball to number 34, who's hit near the line of scrimmage. It'll be any gain, it'll be 1/2 yard. They'll mark it down as a loss.
Play took just a little bit long to develop, and
Umahara, the ball carrier.
That's a play that's been working very well to the left.
Takaguchi once again in the backfield. Araki looking to throw. Quick pass. Complete to number 9.
Number 9 at about the 9.
Umamoto at the 9-yard line. And I'll mark him down at the 8-yard line.
First goal at the 7-yard line.
Brings up first and goal for the Japanese. Araki hands off once again to Inoue. Hit behind the line of scrimmage, no gain. Brings up second and goal from the 8-yard line for the Japanese. Trips left for the Japanese. Single back is Umehara. Araki looking to throw a quick pass out. Complete to number 7. In short of the goal line. Hit hard by the safety. Shin Takasaki, the receiver.
Looks like he's down about the 2. Maybe 2.5.
Quarterback chains inside the 5-yard line. 3rd and goal. Kishimura back in the game. Kyogo Kishimura. Big fullback in the game there, coach. And around to number 11. Near the goal line. Touchdown, a signal from the side judge. Hand off to Tonkas on a
jet sweep.
Jet sweep.
Obviously, tremendously big extra point here. Don't look like he was over by much.
Saeki setting up for the extra point. Snap is back, kick is up, and no good.
We got a flag down.
We do have a flag on the field.
I think there was someone who got a hand on it.
See if we can get a replay of that kick. Different angle. Oh, it went between them.
33 may have, but I don't think so.
A penalty against the Japanese. Be marched off on the kickoff.
Mexico leads 7-6. Today's attendance is 700.
It's one of those trendy things to talk about, but whenever you line up in a critical game, you always mention special teams, and that point may prove to be critical. Who knows?
6:15 remaining in the 3rd quarter. Japan 6, Mexico 7. We got a barn burner going on here, Coach.
It's a great game. We thought it'd be a great game. I'll be honest with you, I didn't think it'd be 7-6 at this point. I thought we'd have a few more points scored. I didn't look for a 45-46 game, but I did think we'd have more than 2 touchdowns at this point, just because of how effective both teams' offenses have been. It's a big penalty.
Saeki kicking from the 20-yard line. Kid's got a good leg. He still gets a good kick out of it. Taken at the 10-yard line by number 4 of Mexico. Ignacio Francisco Guerrero Gonzalez. Brought down at the 24-yard line.
Lost his footing.
Brings up 1st and 10, Mexico from the 24.
So Japan ends up in pretty good field position in lieu of the penalty that was assessed on the kickoff.
Well, both Mexico and Japan's kickers got a lot of leg, Coach, a lot of leg.
Doing a great job today.
Pro set once again for the Mexican offense. Garcia keeps the ball, rolls his right. Taken down for a loss.
Run by the quarterback,
Team Mexico has not been able to establish that kicking, or excuse me, that running game second half like they had going the first half. I think they had over 100 yards rushing in that first half. So far, I think they've got probably a negative 5 or 6, 10 yards in the second half.
Garcia looking to throw. Quick pass out to.
Gets back almost to the original line of scrimmage.
Salvador Sierra, the on the reception. Brings up third and 11 for Mexico.
Three receivers set to the quarterback's left.
Alberto Lopez in the backfield. Next to Garcia. Garcia looking to throw. Scrambles out of the pocket. Bit of trouble there. Gets a couple of yards. Gets about a 6-yard gain on that.
I believe
marked down 30-yard line.
His own man hadn't been his way, he might have picked up that first down.
Brings up fourth down, and the Mexican punter is on the field, number 33. Armando Chiavon. Good kick. Bounce near the 40 and keep rolling. Be downed inside the 20-yard line at the 18.
That was a 52-yard net punt, but a lot of that was the roll. So it wasn't quite the booming punt that the other one was, but it was almost as effective.
That brings Japanese offense on the field, first and 10 from the 18.
They're able to run the ball the last series.
Once again, quarterback Araki in the field. Hand off to Inoue up the left side, still on his feet. Cuts back inside, cuts again outside. Gets a gain of about 9 yards.
Run by number 28, Shuinua. Stopped by Ibrahim Diaz.
He's tackled by the safety. Anytime that's going on, you've got a pretty good play for the most part.
Shuinua has run for 38 yards so far in the game.
Araki hands off to Takaguchi, good enough for a first down, plus 3, brings him inside the 31-yard line.
Ball goes to number 3, Kazuki Takaguchi. Enough to pick up 4 new downs on the 32-yard line.
Brings up a first and 10 from the 32 for the Japanese. Hand off to Inoue. Couple yards gained. Brings up second and 8.
Inoue, number 28, keeps running. Picks up a gain of 3 yards before he's stopped by Mario Soto in Mexico. Second down and 8.
Araki looking to throw the ball, rolling up, still on his feet, heading for the sideline, out of bounds, near the 35. They'll mark him out at the 36-yard line.
Brings up third.
Brings up third down and 7 for Japan. Great adjusting made by the
defensive coordinators in the second half.
Araki looking to throw, puts the ball down the middle, complete, short of the first down. Shin Takasaki on the reception. Hey. Brings up fourth down and a yard and a half for first down. Saeki and company, punting crew back on the field.
His coaches are probably talking to that young man about you need to get across the chain before you hook up.
Good punt taken at the 26-yard line. Mark him down at the 28. Cost us on the reception.
Team Mexico's defense was able to rally up that time. Did give up one first down, but I'm sure they're satisfied with that possession.
Trips left for Garcia. That's a bunch formation, actually. Quick pass to the right side. Read well by the Japanese defense. Reception made by number 88, Kinoshita. Excuse me, I'm reading off the wrong list there. Number 88, Pedro Leonardo Magallanes. Second and 11 for Mexico. Garcia looking to throw. Quick bubble screen out the left side. Tripped up after a gain of about 5 yards. Is number four, Ignacio Francisco Guerra Gonzalez.
The tunnel, certainly started to form.
That brings the end of the third quarter. Wasn't paying attention to the clock there. That went kind of quick.
That was a quick quarter.
And it is the start of the fourth and final quarter of game number 10, the final game of the 2014 World University of America Football Championship here in Uppsala, Sweden. The score is 7-6, Mexico over Japan.
We have said it before, but the winning team will receive a gold medal. Losing team,
and I see they're bringing the trophy out to the far sideline. Japanese team not ready at all. For the Mexican team there. Timeout will be called.
Timeout, Japan. First time out, second half.
Got the Japanese putting their shoes on there, coach.
I'm not quite sure that Team Japan was made aware of the ball ready for play. That's after the quarter. Very unusual that you wouldn't be out there in time.
Mexican coach Horacio Garcia Alponte talking to his boys on the timeout there. Still a little bit of confusion by the Japanese. Garcia and Lopez in the backfield. Double slot formation. Garcia looking to throw. Puts it down the middle to complete the number 19 at the 42-yard line. Jose Barrios on the reception.
Good first play. The team from Mexico to start the fourth quarter.
First and 10 from the 42 for Mexico. Garcia hands up, keeps it himself. Takes off and around left side. Quick pitch to the outside. Complete the number 7. Still on his feet inside the 40-yard line. Bit of a trick play there, Coach. Jose Sanchez on the carry.
Very effective.
Bit of a
play.
Delayed option, I'd call that.
I felt like when I saw it that the ball had came out until there was a returner there, or a ball carrier, rather.
Quick pass to the right side to number 19, Barrios. Gain of about 7 yards on the play. They ran so quick there, the chains weren't even set, Coach. Brings up 2nd and 3. Mexico going with a quick offense here. Double slot formation, single back. Garcia back to throw, looking outside, goes deep to the corner. An almost amazing catch made by
great try.
Number 4. Guerra Gonzalez.
Brings up 3rd and 4.
Brings up 3rd and 3 for Mexico. Guerra looking to find a flag on that play, but didn't get one.
It looked like pretty good coverage from where I was, but I was a long way away.
Trips right. Lopez a single back. Option play. Garcia keeps it himself, gets four new downs at the 21-yard line. Brings up 1st and 10 from the 21 for Mexico. Garcia once again hands off this time to Lopez up the middle. He gets a gain of about 2 yards. Spread formation for the Mexican offense. Lopez Santana in the backfield. Garcia looking to throw, putting it down the right side. Through the hands of a defender. Almost intercepted by number 14 of Japan. Yuto Omori.
Nice route.
Good defense on the Japanese side.
Excellent defense.
Third and 8 for Mexico from the 21-yard line.
Empty set.
Garcia looking to throw once again. Sacked in the backfield. It'll bring up 4th down.
That was a big play. It makes that field goal if they're going to do a field goal attempt 5 yards further.
Field goal kicker Ruvel Kaba on the field.
Quarterback is the holder. I'm quite sure that Japan's aware of that. Coming heavily off of the kicking team's right side.
Kick is up and blocked.
He got it.
Good effort by Team Japan, blocked by number 35. Yuki Ishii on the block kick there. Good effort by the young man coming off the edge.
Amazing effort.
So we can't replay that for you. Here's a replay. Laid himself out, just came flying in there. Good discipline by the defense to back off that ball after it had been blocked. Brings up first and 10 from the 24-yard line. Kishimura taken down outside the tackle box. Lost his helmet on the play.
Nice discipline by the defensive end.
Araki hands off to the running back, number 28, who gets a big gain out to the 46-yard line. Like that kid in Inoue, he runs the ball well.
He is quick.
Araki once again hands off to Inoue. Left side, this time no goal for the Mexican defense. They just stopped him dead in the backfield. They'll mark that down as a 3-yard loss. Araki looking to throw. Quick pass out to Takaguchi. Good enough for the first down. Marked out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Kishimura stopped dead in the backfield for a loss of two. Brings up second and 12 of the Japanese offense. 5 minutes, 36 seconds remaining in the final quarter of play. Kishimura hands off to Takaguchi under the middle, gets back 2.5 yards. Brings up third and close to 10 for the Japanese. Kishimoto looking to throw the ball. Gets the ball out, finally missing his tight end, who was wide open. A lot of pressure.
Flag
coming
in the backfield. It might be roughing the passer.
They're moving that flag up a bit there. Chop block against the Japanese.
Bring up.
Chop block called against Umehara. That'll be declined by the Mexican defense, and that'll bring up fourth down. Temperature dropped about 5 degrees when this wind picked up here.
Not the regular punter.
They got the running back Takahashi in the backfield to punt. Lopsided line. Defense calls a timeout. Interesting punt formation there.
That's the same formation they've been using most of the time except for one, but it wasn't the same punter. I think Team Mexico felt he might run it, and so did I. I think maybe they're going to go for
normal punters on the field now. Saeki. Back to return from Mexico is Barros. Saiki's punt is a low roller. Bounces off a couple of players. Recovered by Mexico. Flag's coming in late there. Personal foul against number 77 of Japan. That'll result in a 15-yard penalty from the spot and first down. Chinese team in front of us rooting on the Mexican team. Four minutes, 48 seconds remaining in the final quarter. It's Japan 6, Mexico 7. Hand off to Lopez, still on his feet. Gets out to a 47-yard line. That'll be a 7-yard gain. Brings up second and 3 for Mexico. It's all about clock control now, Coach.
Yeah, I thought maybe Japan would go for it. on the last fourth down.
Garcia letting the clock roll down close in under the 10-second market. Garcia hands off to number one, Salvador Sierra. That'll move the chains and the ball across the 50-yard line. Marked down at the 48. First and 10 for Mexico from the Japanese 48-yard line. Mexico taking their time with their huddles, burning some clock. Game clock is down to 7. Garcia keeping the ball. He'll be tackled for a loss. Bring up 2nd and 11 from the 49.
Team Japan's only got 2 timeouts, but they're about to where they need to use them.
Hand off to Lopez in the background. Still on his feet, moving towards the end zone. It looks like he might go all the way. Knocked out of bounds at the 3-yard line. One heck of a run by number 2. Juan Antonio Lopez Santana.
I believe if I was Japan, I'd let him score right now.
Mexico calls the timeout with 1:49 left on the clock. Interesting that Mexico would take a timeout with the clock ticking down, ball on the 3-yard line. Which any which way you look at this game, it's one heck of an outcome. Score right
great
now
game.
Is 1:50 remaining in the final quarter of play is Mexico 7, Japan 6.
I guess in lieu of all the offensive shows we've seen throughout the tournament, we're due for a defensive struggle. A struggle highlighted by defenses. I guess maybe I should say it that way.
Pro set for the Mexican offense. Garcia hands off to the fullback. Flag comes flying in. Might get about a yard on that play.
I think we're going to have an offensive holding.
Number 39, Sandra Escobar. We have the flag on the play.
holding against the Mexican offense.
I'm not sure that's helping Japan.
That'll move the ball back 10 yards to the...
It's not declined.
Japan has declined the penalty. Bring up second down and goal from the 3-yard line. Like you said, Coach, there be a smart move for the Japanese to let them score right here. Leave them with a minute and 43 seconds to try to get into the end zone and a 2-point conversion. Hand off to Lopez. Wallace is in the middle untouched. That brings us to 13-6. Japanese have blocked one field goal. Personal foul against the Japanese. It'll move the kickoff up of 15 yards. Drove Lakaba on the field to kick. Clock adjustment to 1:30. Garcia waiting for a signal from the sideline. Japanese in close, almost close enough to block it, but not quite. The kick is good. That brings us to 14-6. With 1 minute 30 seconds remaining in the final quarter of play. Interesting situation for the Japanese here.
Yeah, they got penalized on the touchdown. I'm not quite sure what occurred, but it was certainly unnecessary. Well, the breeze is picking up a little bit, and a little bit of water in the air.
That'll be a kick from the 50-yard line. The Mexican kicker, Ruvel Caba, has been pounding them in close to the goal line. He might just put this one through the uprights, Coach.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to have a return anyway, unless Team Mexico chooses to kick some variation of a sky kick, that kind of thing.
Wouldn't be surprised to see an onside attempt here either.
Well, I think they'll kick it out of the end zone is what I think they'll do.
A good high kick, short. It'll drop at the 5-yard line, taken by number 7. Change of direction, turns it back up a little bit. Still on his feet, taken down inside the 10. That'll be marked down as a 4-yard return to the 9-yard line.
Kickoff goes to number 7.
Takasaki taken down hard on the return there.
Hard to get clear across the field.
One minute, 25 seconds
And 90 yards to go for the Japanese, the touchdown. First and 10 from the 10-yard line. Araki throwing deep. Ball intended for number one, Maeda.
Incomplete, second down and 10. 1 minute and 20 seconds.
Overthrew his receiver by a couple of yards there.
WUC.
Brings up second and 10 for the Japanese. Minute 20 seconds remaining on the clock in the final quarter of play. Araki looking to throw once again, straight down the middle of the field. Through the arms, well defended. Well defended by number 11 there. Ball intended for number 19.
Suzuki,
the intended receiver.
Abraham
Diaz Alcaron is the defender on the play.
1 minute and 15 seconds remaining.
Trips left for the Japanese. Motion out of the backfield. Araki looking to throw. Runs to his right. Quick throw out to Suzuki. Good enough for first down. Close to the sideline, but not quite out of bounds. Hit the 30-yard line. They stop the clock just to move the chains.
Pick up four new downs.
Quick snap by the quarterback just to get the good ball and stop the clock. 59 seconds remaining in the
tournament.
Tournament.
We'd have to score a touchdown, get a two-point conversion, tie it up. We'd go into overtime. Still a possibility.
As the rain is starting to come down on the arena here. Umbrellas opening, hoods coming up. Araki looking to throw once again. This time he throws it out of bounds. Brings up third down and 10 for Japanese. This is more or less a do or die play right here, coach. They need to get the chains moved or get into Mexican territory. Araki looking to throw once again. Pressure coming off the backside. He'll tuck it and run this time. He'll only get to the first down marker, but that's enough to move the chains.
They'll say he knew where it was. Great heads up play for the quarterback. He knew exactly where his chain was.
Leaves us with 47 seconds remaining in the game.
47 seconds remaining.
Clock has stopped. He got out of bounds. They got four new downs. 10 yards closer, but time is running out.
60 yards to go. A field goal won't help here. Araki looking to throw. Trying to set up a bit of a middle screen there.
Well diagnosed by a defensive line. They felt the offensive line let them go, and they stopped.
Brings up second and 10 for the Japanese from the 40-yard line. Araki looking to throw once again. Ball went off an offensive lineman. Ball intended for the running back Inoue out of the backfield.
35 seconds remaining of the game.
brings us to third and 10 from the 40-yard line, 35 seconds remaining in the final quarter of the tournament. Rocky once again to throw. Down the middle of the field, a wide open receiver, number one. Heading for the sideline. Gets out of bounds. Does not get out of bounds at the 34. They move the chains. We're now in Mexico territory.
I'm sure the quarterback will clock the ball as soon as the chains are set. It'll probably be a second or two runoff after the... Whoa.
First, that bring up second and 10 for
the
Japanese after quick snap to stop the clock.
21 seconds remaining.
21 seconds remaining. Japan on the move. Inside the 35-yard line at the 34, second and the 10. Araki to throw once again. This time out to number 89, a big tight end, Mizuno, who does get out of bounds after a 3-yard gain.
Picks up a gain of 3, third and 7.
That'll bring up third down and 7 for the Japanese.
Seconds is the key.
They've utilized the clock quite well in this last minute of the game. Araki back to throw. Quick throw out the sideline. Reception at the 20-yard line. Inbounds. And Japan calls timeout with 9 seconds on the clock, Coach. They're moving the ball. They're moving the chains.
They got probably 2 shots at the end zone. 9 seconds. He can't scramble and have 2 shots, but... drops back and throw it.
Hope for the best.
Ball's right at the 20-yard line.
Make the jet sweep. Araki going to the corner of the end zone, overthrows his receiver. Leaves it with 3 seconds on the clock. Coach, we got time for one last play.
Yes, sir. Incomplete pass. We have 3 seconds remaining of the game.
Japan takes their final timeout of the game. 3 seconds left on the clock. The score is 14 for Mexico, 6 for Japan. In the 2014 World University American Football Championship here in Uppsala, Sweden.
I look for them to be in the trips formation to the field. I believe they were going to bring number 89 down the middle of the field on one of the routes. Probably a corner route by somebody else. Thrilling finish here to the World Championships here in Uppsala, as you've said many times, partner.
Araki and company, last time they'll be on the field today for an offensive series. Araki looking to throw, pressure coming from the outside. Ball thrown into the end zone, out of bounds.
Whoa, I thought he caught the ball.
Look, he did catch the ball, but they called him out of bounds. I'd like to see the replay on that one. Get a replay of it here, see what the camera shows us.
A very tight, entertaining fun game.
Good bullet pass into the end zone there. Araki catches it. Couldn't tell from that angle, see if we can get the ground angle on it.
Like to see it in slow-mo like you do some of the other.
See if we can't get a shot from the end zone on that last play. It was a beautiful play.
There it is.
There it is. He catches the ball, feet in bounds.
Looked like a good catch if he wasn't juggling the ball. There's no way I can tell if he was juggling it.
Well, that brings us to the end of the 2014 World University American Football Championship in Uppsala, Sweden. The host nation will be Mexico for the next championship, I do believe. That will be played in Mexico City.
Well, that was a great, great contest. As we said before the broadcast, or before the game began, not before the broadcast began, but before the game began, early part of the broadcast, that they saved the best to last. I don't know that that was intentional. But it certainly worked out that way. And it was a fitting conclusion. The gold medal was riding on the game, so couldn't have been staged any better.
We will start with Team Japan, where the Most Valuable Player award goes to number 12, Yoshiro Araki.
Yoshiro Araki will receive the MVP for the Japanese team. Quarterback did a wonderful job.
Somewhat bittersweet, I'm sure, on his part. I know they were looking forward to winning the game, taking the gold medal back to Japan with them.
And in Team Mexico, the Most Valuable Player award goes to number 55, Mauricio Salazar.
MVP of Mexico is
6.5 tackles, 2 tackles.
Big linebacker from.
And a great impact.
Mexico, Mauricio Salazar Cavazos.
He will be rewarded souvenirs from Sweden, from the game sponsors, from Swedish Agriculture University and Uppsala University.
Well, Coach, it's been a wonderful week. 10 games of football.
I certainly appreciate being able to work alongside you for this tournament, these few games. Been interesting, been a learning experience for me, that's for sure.
Yeah, well, my next broadcast, you'll be on the sideline for the 86ers, and I'll be up in the box.
That might be entertaining from a different standpoint. Who knows? But
and the table for the tournament is coming up here. Mexico on top in first place with a plus 178, 100%. And Japan in second with a plus 188 with 75%. Japan suffered their first loss of the tournament today in the final game. Sweden bringing up third place with a minus 56%. Then Finland in fourth with a minus 112, 25%. And China bringing up the rear to fifth place, but not to be last. To be the happiest team on the field, I'd give that trophy to the Japanese all day, or the Chinese all day long.
They did a great job under the circumstances that we said during some of their games that they didn't have very long to prepare, so weren't quite as effective in some of the things that they tried to do, but were outstanding sports, outstanding attitudes, that kind of thing, as you've made reference to. just a great situation. As I said, some of the times I've never been in an Olympic situation. This nearest thing that I've been to, when you have athletes from different countries lining up and playing each other, don't speak a common language. It's a unique experience for me, and I think it was for most of the athletes out here, and it's been a lot of fun.
Well, for Will Peterson and Mike Kersley, that is the end of our commentary for this tournament. We'll leave you with the ending ceremony and highlights. And we thank you for listening in and watching our broadcast, and thank you and good night from Uppsala, Sweden.
Players to march to the 40-yard line, please.
Gentlemen. Now for the closing speech of the president of the organizing committee and vice president in FISU, the International University Sports Federation, Mr. Stefan Bad.
Dear friends, athletes, officials, thank you again for attending this first edition of the World University Championships in American football. We have seen some great games played here at Österängen Uppsala, and we are happy to have had you here. The games we have seen have been played in a good atmosphere and also with good sportsmanship. Let me specially recognize the work and the efforts from the Chinese team coming here for the first time in their natural way. Thank you very much. The game we've seen today between Japan and Mexico was probably one of the best games we ever seen in Sweden in American football. Let me also take this opportunity to say thank you to the stakeholders behind this event. The Uppsala University, the Swedish Agricultural University, City of Uppsala, Fyris Hall, the Swedish American Football Federation, of course, the local university club in American football, Uppsala 86. In this event, we have also worked with more than 150 volunteers. Thank you for your work. The next edition in this sport will be organized in Mexico. We all know that, in 2016. And I'm sure the Mexican host will perform an excellent event when we go to Monterrey 2016. I wish you all the best in your preparation. And again, from my side, thank you for coming to Uppsala. Thank you for participating in this event. Thank you very much.
And we would also like to recognize all the officials been participating in this World University Championship. Please give them a warm hand. Before we begin with the Buendel Award, we would like Team China to please step forward to receive your diplomas and official gifts from the organizing committee. And at this occasion, we would also like to recognize the fact that the Chinese team for the first time ever participates internationally in American football. And for this, we're presenting a small token of appreciation. Thank you very much, China. Finnish team to please step forward to receive your diplomas and official gifts from the organizing committee. Medals we will be awarded by Mr. Dusan Halar, the FISU Medical Committee Member, Mr. Tarmo Jackson, the FISU International Control Committee Member, Mr. Rupe Noronen, the FISU Technical Delegate, Mr. Stefan Berg, the President of the Organizing Committee, Mr. Josef Åman, Secretary General of the Swedish University Sports Federation, Mr. Martin Söderberg, Project Manager of the Championship, and Tommy Viking, the IFAF President. But first, please get Team China back to the prize table to get the award, please. And now to the awarding of the medals. In third place and bronze medalist, we congratulate Team Sweden. Victor Thoresson, Alex Josef, Jonathan Boklund, Hampus Hellemark, Carl Edin, Robert Willemsson, Fabian Söderberg, Joakim Nilsson, Tommy Gustafsson, Jimmy Palmborg, Joshua Akena, Felix Lövenborg, Mikael Sander, Peter Ljungstedt, Mattias Liljestam, Chris Reiby, Andreas Jonsson, Anders Johansson, Kristoffer Willén, Johan Engren, Jakob Veslén, Johannes Nilsson, Max Hederström, Assar Hohn, Anton Holmberg, Henrik Nilsson, Robin Alexandersson, Jakob Karlsson, Rickard Hellgren, Kristoffer Livebrant, Daniel Risberg, Sebastian Eriksson, Linus Larsson, Daniel Söderberg, Jonathan Wahlgren, Anton Ulenius, Erik Bari, Jesper Grossman, Kenneth Frykler, Robert Stålhandske Persson och Marcus Janback. Congratulations and a warm applause one more time for Team Sweden, bronze medalists in this first World University Championship. And now for the second place and silver medalist, we congratulate Team Japan. Team Japan consists of Shingo Maeda, Genki Takeda, Katsuki Takaguchi, Kevin Coughlin, Shin Takasaki, Hiroyuki Umemoto, Kyogo Kishimura, Tatsuya Tonka, Yoshiro Araki,
Takuya Iwamoto, Yoto Omori, Shintaro Saeki, Yu Kitamura, Takuya Ishiuchi, Keita Suzuki, Kiyosuke Kamiyama, Shota Oseki, Shu Inoue, Akira Onuki, Shuhei Miyagawa, Shun Umehara, Yuki Ishii, Hirokazu Zuyushi, Shogo Makatani, Keisuke Ota, Naoki Hayashi, Ryuhei Kajibara, Junpei Shibata, Itsuki Kato, Gendai Takechi, Masaki Hattori, Tomoaki Sakaguchi, Kohei Yamashita, Ian Uesawa, Hiroshi Sakaguchi, Jun Tomokuni, Hayato Araki, Moniyuki Kinoshita, Yui Mizuno, Makoto Kajiwara, Kento Ikinaga, Yui Fujitani, Daichi Shibata, Sakuyi Seike, and Ryota Takahashi. We congratulate Team Japan for the second place and silver medalists in this first World University Championship. And now it's time to present the winners of this first tournament. Gold medalist Team Mexico! Mexico consists of Sierra Salvador, Juan Lopez, Alberto Lopez, Ignacio Guerra, Jesus Sosa, Ricardo Cervantes, Jose Sanchez, Miguel Montes, Fernando Rubalcaba, Ruben Vertiguel, Ibrahim Diaz, Alejandro Garcia, Jose Fernandez, Fernando Chavarria, Carlos Espinosa, Jose Barrios, Alejandro Cepeda, Enrique Enriquez, Casil Ruiz, Rodrigo Arias, Armando Chiavon, Gerardo Elizondo, Sergio Vega, Sergio Escobar, Nicolas Compla, Owen Ruiz, Ulysses Garcia, Francisco Machado, Omar Romero, Mauricio Salazar, Cesar Juarez, Alejandro Castillo, Cesar Balestra, Marco Martin, Luis Montin, Emmanuel Alonso, Pavel Fischer, Axel Valero, Ulysses Tubar, Pedro Marianas, Jonathan Colorado, Francisco Kraus, Mario Soto, and Juan Romero. Congratulations to the first ever winners of the World University Championship in American football, Team Mexico!